Hey friends, welcome back to Bitfumes. I'm your host Sarthak and you can also call me Ankur. This is a channel where I talk about the Laravel and the cool thing about the Laravel. So if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Okay, so in this episode, we are going to learn about the pagination in the Laravel. And this is the request from, we have Amrul Khan and Ahmed Wahi. So you can see I have written every request I have got from you guys. So we will obviously going to learn about the CMS admin, getting IP address and last login, creating the manual login registration, GitHub, Sublime Text, Ajax. Ajax is requested by most of the subscribers. So we will going to learn Ajax very soon. Actually, I am busy on a project, so I am not able to concentrate on creating a project of Ajax because I want to show you Ajax system with a mini project. Okay, so let's learn about the pagination, and it's very easy. You can see this is the documentation of the Laravel about the pagination. So in the last episode we have learned about the seeding of the database. So let's see. So here I am in the database where I have just seeded the 10 random users inside my users table and obviously inside our tests table. So if you don't know about the seeding, so don't worry, check out the link below in the description, or you can search for the seeding in my channel. Okay, so let's go and create a pagination. Obviously I don't have any view for that. Let's go quickly and create a view. So I will go to my Sublime Text and go to resources folder, views folder, and here I will create a view called, let's say, pagination.blade.php. okay, that's good. And I will use HTML5 markup, and here I will say just pagination, and here I will use, let's say, div row, and obviously after that div container. Okay, so here I will create a table with a table head which says table head, which has heading of the name and email. Okay, so let's see, we have the name and email of our user. So name and email, and here inside our body, so t body, here I will say table row and table data, and this data will be like the name and email. Obviously we are going to fill these two with the data from our database. So let's just check out the database. So we have this database created in the last episode. So just get this data from our controllers. So we have to create a controller also. For that we have to open a command prompt, and I will go to this folder, and there's a shortcut for opening command prompt for a specific folder. So let's press the shift key and press right click anywhere. And you can see now we have the open command window here. If we just right click here, we does not have that that option. So with the shift key pressed, when I press right click, then we get the open command window here. So let's go, and we can see we are on directly on that folder. So I will just type php artisan serve, and obviously we have to create another command prompt. So php artisan make controller name pagination, and it's created. So let's go here, and we have the pagination, and now here I will say pagination, and let's say users, otherwise it will be confusing. So here I will return view of pagination, not .php. okay, so let's check this system. So we will go to our localhost, and here I will see users. So we does not have any route, so let's just quickly create the route. So here I will just delete this and create a route of get which says users, go to pagination at users, and let's go click refresh. Now we have the system here which we have created in the pagination.blade.php. Now we just have to connect our system with the database, so obviously we need to import the model, use app/user, and we have imported. Now here I will use, so users is equal to users, it will be capital, not users, it's user and all. Now with the compact method, I will just pass this data to our view, and now I will go to pagination.blade.php, and here I will create a for each loop, and here I will say users as user, and just get it here, delete this, and here I will just echo that out. So here I will say user name, and obviously user email, that's good. And let's see, everything is correct, yes. So let's go click refresh, and you can see we have everything correct. So you can make this look better by using the bootstrap, but for the sake of time I'm not using the bootstrap. So let's just see, we have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 users. So let's just quickly get here a table data with which says the loop index. What this do, this will just create a numbering of the loop. That means every time loop goes, it will create the number for that loop. Okay, so let's go click refresh, and you can see it is start from 0, but we want to start from 1, so +1, and now we have 1 to 10 numbering. Now the time for the pagination, it's extremely simple, you know why? Because I just have to do one thing. So what I will do, I will just delete this all, and here I will say paginate simple, and here the number of data I want to show in single page. So we have 2 here. So let's go click refresh, and you will get an error because the pagination spelling is incorrect. So it will be paginate. Okay. Refresh, and you will get the data here. So you can see it's extremely simple. So now what I have to do, I have to create a links to get to next page. Now for the links, you just have to say here users, not user, it says users, and here links. So now go here, hit refresh, and you can see we have the pagination's links here. So I will just put it down so that we get pagination link downside. And you can obviously select this pagination system according to your view. That means if you use bootstrap, it will be awesome, it will be inlined, and you will get the thing correct. So you can do obviously, but let's just see the result. So when I hit on the second page, it will give me the second. When I on the third, fourth, fifth, and you get each and every result here. So if you want to customize this, let's see how it look like. It says UL of class pagination. So what I can do, I can just create a style here, style and dot pagination, and inside this I want li to be display inline. Let's go hit refresh, and you can see it is inlined, and obviously you can do styling according to you, and it will give you the awesome results. So this is the simple thing. And so the next thing I want to introduce is the simple pagination. So what you have to do for the simple pagination, just go to pagination, type here simple paginate, hit refresh, and you will get no change except the links here. So in the simple pagination, you does not get any number in between the next and previous, only you get the next and previous links. So here next and previous links. Okay, so if you have a project where you want the user to go each and every step, don't want to skip, then this is the way to do that thing. So in the next episode, we are going to learn about the pagination in the relationship, eloquent relationship paginations. So stay tuned, and if you have any doubt in this episode or in anywhere of my videos, please feel free to comment. Follow me on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram, and you can also message me your problems, errors on Facebook, and share this video with your developer friends so that everyone get the knowledge of best thing called Laravel. And I'm going to complete each and every request one by one as I get the enough time to complete these requests. And don't worry, I will complete request very soon. And the most important thing, Ajax series is coming shortly. I am working on the mini project of Ajax, so don't worry and sorry for the delay, and you will get the best thing from Bitfumes. And don't forget to subscribe, that is very important thing. So we will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.